Hello folks, Scott with Dallas Paint Correction and Auto Detailing here in Dallas, Texas. I want to start getting into some more advanced stuff when it comes to auto detailing. I'm going to try to do this relatively quickly. I want to remove this badge, this emblem, whatever the cool kids are calling it these days. I want to get it off, and I want to get it off quickly. I want to talk about a couple things that people do. I watch YouTube as well, probably like you. I see guys using heat guns, incredibly effective. If you want to use a heat gun, that's fine. I'm going to show you a way. There's four ways that I can take an emblem off. I will go over them over the next couple of weeks on each process, which one makes more sense to me. And the very last one, I don't use a heat gun, I don't use anything, and I get this emblem off in about 30 seconds. But that will be later on down the road. Just been doing it too long. I want to talk about liability. If you're a professional detailer and you're watching people remove these emblems and they're telling you to use a heat gun, again, highly effective to do it, but there's some issues. Clear coat doesn't like to get all that hot. We got to be careful how hot it gets. It will start to get spongy. It will start to break down. You got to be careful with the heat gun. So today, yes, it's going to require some tools. I'm going to take some of the liability out. If some of you are thinking about doing this for the first time, want to put it in your bag of tricks, put it on your website, offer it to your customers, I want to show you a way to do this that lowers your liability. That's the most important thing to me. The last thing I want to do is ruin the clear coat, right? That's just going to be expensive. It's a repaint job at that point. So I want to show you how I'm going to do this with limiting my liability as much as I can. So what I'm going to do, I have a steamer, right? You guys have seen the steamer before. It's made by McCulloch. It only gets to about 250 degrees. That's kind of important to understand. Yes, there's the VX5000. That also gets a little bit hotter. You can use the VX5000 in this case. That's fine. I just like this sucker because I don't have to overthink it. It's only going to get up to 250 degrees. I'm going to rest it on this emblem, go over it quickly, and then I'm going to pull the emblem off really fast. But the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take the head off this pyramid head off the steamer. I'm going to get my steam going, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to come in here and steam and blow my steam around the edges of the emblem. The reason why I do this, folks, is to blow out any type of debris, dirt. You probably saw some of that stuff. You figure out how you want to remove it from the paint. I'm just using a microfiber towel here. Somebody's going to say he's scratching the paint. I'm not overthinking the moment. It's an old truck. But I've blown out all that dirt around that emblem. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the head on the steamer and I'm going to rest it right on the emblem and heat it up for a couple of minutes. Maybe not even that. I'm not worried about the moment. I'm not worried about using a heat gun. Am I getting the clear coat too hot? Well, guess what? It's getting pretty warm right now, but I'm not worried about the clear coat melting on me, blistering on me. This steamer is going to allow the steam, the heat, to transfer through the emblem to the double-sided tape effectively and safely to remove your liability if you do this professionally. Okay. I think I've gotten that hot enough. In fact, I don't need to heat it at all, so I'm not really all worried about it, but I'll show you that trick in the future. I'm going to put some gloves on. These gloves happen to be something I bought at Sherman Williams. They're like those rubber-dipped gloves, because I'm going to wrap my hand in what I call fishing line. It's exactly what it's called. I'm going to take some fishing line, and I'm going to wrap my hands around the fishing line. The reason why I want these rubber gloves on my hands is so that I don't pinch my hands. So now I'm going to simply go in and just put my fishing line behind it, and I'm going to make small, soft cuts and watch this emblem say bye-bye, Scott. Whoops, sometimes the fishing line breaks. Don't panic. Get yourself some more fishing line. Go in there and keep going. Just small little strokes to get to the end of the emblem and say goodbye. I watch people use heat guns. I watch people, I don't know what people do, but they overthink the moment. So here we go. We've got that off there. I want to take my dry microfiber towel and just clean up around the surface, right? Now what I have is this double-sided tape, which is the biggest part of the process. I want to get that off there. Folks, the next tool I'm going to use scares some people at times, but it's called the 3M eraser wheel. This is something, if you're a professional detailer, you want to get your hands on this thing. You want to learn it. You want to use it. It'll make your life easy. But I'm just going to simply go in there and take my 3M eraser wheel and zip off that double-sided tape, and then we're going to get to the fun part, because this is the part where people really screw up. They'll take a plastic razor blade. Maybe they'll try to peel it with their fingers. They'll get blisters on the end of their fingers. I don't need these gloves anymore. This is silly. But this is where the nightmare begins. This is where most of the people will scratch the paint trying to remove that double-sided tape. Again, you could sit here if you want slowly and try to pull it off, but I want to beat to the punch. Actually, this stuff's going to come off pretty quick. But I want to show you what the 3M eraser wheel can do. I'll go in here and whip this off pretty quickly. I know when people see that 3M eraser wheel, they panic. They go, oh my God, I'm ruining the paint. Well, you gotta use some common sense. It's like an eraser on a pencil. If you use it to remove a pencil mark off paper, you take your eraser, you'll remove the pencil, the lead pencil from the paper, but if you keep going, you'll blow through the paper. The same effect for the 3M eraser wheel. Just get in there and do what you gotta do. Also, if you noticed, I started over here because the debris field is shooting this way towards the tire. I don't want to work into my debris field, so I want to make sure I'm going in the opposite direction of which way I'm shooting that double-sided tape. Now I'm simply going to take a microfiber towel and just come in here and just remove all this little residue, right? All that nasty stuff from the double-sided tape and the eraser wheel. Now what I have left, I don't know if the camera's showing it, there'll be some sticky residue left behind. It's one thing to get the double-sided tape off the car. Now I've got this sticky residue. There's guys out there that love Rapid Remover, an amazing chemical, great chemical, love it. It's great, but it costs somewhere around $60 a gallon. You guys have heard me talk about citral. I use it to remove bugs, tar, all that good stuff. I'm just gonna put some on my little microfiber applicator, and I'm going to come in here and simply remove that glue residue. 1, 2, 3. This stuff cost half of what Rapid Remover costs. And I'm just going to go in here and pick up that residue. I'm not scratching the paint. I'm being as gentle as possible. This stuff will just dissolve. Glue, tar, completely clear coat safe. It's just going to completely annihilate that stuff. It's awfully slick under the surface. I'm not scratching the paint. This stuff is breaking down that residue so freaking quickly. I don't have any sticky stuff left over. And now I'm done. I'm going to mop up with a microfiber towel and just get that stuff out of the way. What I have, folks, oops, I picked up some of the dust from the 3M eraser wheel. Be careful, don't do that. What I have done is completely remove that emblem in what? 9 minutes. Actually, I removed the emblem, yeah, about 9 minutes, okay, 10 minutes. I removed that emblem quickly. I took advantage of the steam. I wasn't worried about it hurting the clear coat. It only gets up to 250 degrees. When you've got the steamer gun completely up against that emblem, that heat can transfer through the emblem a lot quicker than a heat gun, because usually you're holding the heat gun way back here and you're hoping over a period of time it will transfer through the emblem and start loosening up that double-sided tape. Then I take my 3M eraser wheel. I know it scares people when you use it, just common sense. Get in there and do what you gotta do. Don't hang around too long. Get that double-sided tape off the car. And then use a incredibly effective glue adhesive remover, because it's gonna be sticky even though you remove the double-sided tape. Some people will use Goo Gone. It just takes too long. I wanna skip to the punch. I have customers that may have this emblem on this side of the car, an emblem on the other side of the car. I can remove both emblems and the glue residue in less than 10 minutes if I'm not making a video. Now, and I'll go into this in the future, what do you want to do? There's times that, again, because the emblem was on there, the sun is kind of baking the exposed area of the paint, right? So it oxidizes. It kind of fades a little bit. When you remove that emblem, you're exposing fresh paint behind there. You may have to polish, you may have to compound to kind of blend this panel in, and I'll go into that in the future. I just wanted to show you one of the quickest ways, the fastest ways, the safest ways, and limiting your liability to remove emblems. It does not take long if you know what you're doing. I have been doing it for a long time. I want to help you guys. There you go. What do you guys think? Do you like that process? I don't see why you couldn't. It just takes so quickly. Love you all. Take care.